Okay, good afternoon, Vandan. Today we are going to discuss briefly about discrete time Fourier transform, DTFT, discrete time Fourier transforms. Before going to this, let us recap about LTI systems, linear time invariant systems. Suppose x of n is my input sequence and h of n is the impulse response of the LTI system, then the concerned output sequence I am going to get is linear convolution of x of n with h of n. And we know that convolution operation is commutative. We can try to write this like this also, h of n convolution with x of n. This is a mathematical expression for convolution. Sigma k goes minus infinity to infinity, x of n minus k into h of k. Otherwise, you can write like this also, sigma k goes minus infinity to infinity, x of k, h of n minus k. Due to commutative property. This is linear convolution. Okay, have you heard about eigenfunctions? Or, okay, forget about functions. Let me think about eigenvectors. Have you heard about eigenvectors? Yeah, what is eigenvector? Ax bar should be equals to? Yeah, can someone answer? What should be this one?
Lambda x.
Yeah, lambda x bar. For example, A is m cross n, x is n cross 1 vector, where lambda is a scalar constant. This is known as eigenvalue. And this is known as eigenvector for this matrix A. See, the advantage of eigenvectors is as follows. For example, if I am able to represent some signal, some vector z bar as a combination of eigenvectors. Just for example, let me consider 2x1 bar plus 3x2 bar. Let me call x1 bar, x2 bar as my eigenvectors. The concerned eigenvalue for this one is lambda 1. Concerned eigenvalue for this one is lambda 2. These two are the eigenvectors. It means Ax1 bar equals to lambda 1 x1 bar. Ax2 bar equals to lambda 2 into x2 bar. Suppose if I am able to represent my vector as a linear combination of these two eigenvectors, the advantage I am going to get is the advantage I am going to get. Can someone answer? Then what will be my Az bar? I can go for linearity operation, right? 3x2 bar. This will be 2 into Ax1 bar. Ax1 bar is nothing but lambda 1 x1 bar, right? 2 times lambda 1 x1 bar plus 3 times lambda 2 x2 bar, right? Instead of going for this matrix multiplication, I can simply go for addition of vectors, right? Addition of vectors, linear combination of vectors. If I am able to express somehow z bar as a linear combination of eigenvectors, this is the benefit I am going to get. I can try to reduce the number of computations required for Az bar operation, right? It's a benefit I am going to get. The same benefit we are going to get with this. Instead of doing matrix multiplication, I can simply go for linear combination of this thing. If I am able to decompose this vector as a linear combination of eigenvectors, that's a benefit I am going to get. I can reduce my computations. If m equal to 10,000, for example, n equal to some 10,000, then that is very huge, right? Computing Ax bar required a huge amount of time. You need more number of computations. Instead of that, I can go with such things, right? This looks much easier compared to this one. Yeah, similarly, we'll try to go for eigenfunctions. This is eigenvector because x bar is a vector. Similarly, we have something like eigenfunctions. You might heard about this in signals and systems course. For example, if I consider the response of that LDI system, is the response of the LDI system. For example, x of n equals to e power j omega n for all n belongs to z. Then, do you think this can be an eigenfunction? Can it be eigenfunction for this? See, if you want to prove this is an eigenfunction, then what we need to do is we need to prove somehow that some constant into x of n. We need to prove something like this, where this constant can be complex number. Can be a complex constant, this constant. If I'm able to prove somehow like this, or you can go with standard notation, like eigenvalue notation, that's also fine. Lambda can be complex constant. If I am able to prove that this y of n equals to some constant into x of n, then I can call this x of n as my eigenfunction. Because y of n equals to transformation of x of n, right? Transformation of x of n equals to lambda into x of n. If I got something like this, where lambda is complex constant, then I can call it as eigenfunction and I can call it as eigenvalue. Like that, I can say. If I try to substitute e power j omega n into this expression, what I am going to get is, yeah, what is this then? E power j omega into, yeah, can someone speak out? What is this?
N minus k?
Yes, this is n minus k. I'm replacing n with n minus k, right? X of n equal to e power j omega n. X of n minus k equal to e power j omega into n minus k. Now I can try to split this into two parts. E power a plus b equals to e power a into e power b, right? I can use that e power j omega n into e power minus j omega k. Now, can I take this outside summation e power j omega n? Because summation is with respect to k, this is independent of k, this is constant with respect to k, right? I can take this outside of this summation. Then finally, I am going to end up with this one. We have n equals to, after taking this outside of summation, sigma k equals to minus infinity plus infinity, h of k into e power minus j omega k. See, e power minus j omega into h of k, right? Can someone comment about this one? X of n into some constant. Something like some complex constant. I already call this lambda like h of e power j omega. Sigma k goes to minus infinity plus infinity. H of k e power minus j omega k. This can be a complex constant. This is a complex constant. Because see, for example, if your h of n or h of k is a real sequence, is a real one, even though this is real, due to this, this can be complex, right? Real into some complex number you are having, right? D power minus j omega k. Due to this factor, the final h of e power j omega we are going to get can be a complex constant. It's a single number, right? But we are getting some complex number. We may get complex number. That can be real also, or that can be complex also, this number. I can try to write like this. V of n equals to h of e power j omega into e power j omega n, like the second iterator, where this is nothing but x of n in our example. Now I can call this as my eigenvalue, h of e power j omega, and this can be called as eigenfunction, because finally I got something like this, right? Transformation of x of n equals to h of e power j omega, this is some complex number, into x of n, like this I got when x of n equal to e power j omega. Then I can call this one as eigenfunction, I can call this one as eigenvalue, and this is known as DTFT, discrete time Fourier transform. Discrete time Fourier transform of h of n. DTFT of h of n. See, no need to worry about this whether this is k or n, because I can simply change the name of this from k to n everywhere. In base of k, I can keep n, I can keep n, I can keep n, right? If I want. Then no need to worry that much about this one. This can be known as DTFT, discrete time Fourier transform of h of n. The time domain, right? This is frequency domain. Like that you can think. And the benefit of eigenfunction is as follows. This is h of n, impulse response of LTI system. Then can someone answer what is the output for f n equals to? Yeah, what is this? H of e power j omega into h of e power j omega into e power j omega n, right? Where h of e power j omega equals to sigma k equals to minus infinity plus infinity h of k e power minus j omega k. Like this I can write. Okay, now I will try to ask something. Suppose input is e power j omega n, then what will be the output? See, in place of omega I have omega 1. Then what should the output? Same thing, right? In base of omega, I should have omega 1 here. Suppose if my input is omega 2, then in place of omega, I'll have omega 2 both sides. Suppose my input is e power j omega 1 n plus e power j omega 2 n, then what is the output I am going to get? Yeah, can someone answer what is the output? This is linear time invariant system, right? Linear. Yeah, what is the output? Yeah, I can speak out. Due to linearity property of this
linear
system,
combination of
yes,
y1 of n plus y2 of n.
Y1 of n corresponds to this, right? H of e power j omega,
yes,
1
sir.
into
e to the power of j omega 1 n.
Plus h of e power j omega 2 into e power j omega 2 n. Suppose if I have like this sigma k equals to, for example, 1 to 5, just for example, some alpha k into e power j omega k n, where alpha k is nothing but some constant. This is some constant. Then the response I am going to get is as follows. Sigma k goes to 1 to 5 due to linearity property, right? I'll try to find the response of this. Response of this is nothing but h of e power j omega k. into e power j omega kn. So this is the benefit I am going to get. Suppose if I am able to represent my input something like this as a linear combination of complex exponential sequences, then I can get the output very easily, right? I can get the output very easily. Output of this one, this thing, I can find the output a little bit easily by applying this eigenfunction property. It means if I know this one, then I can find the output for any of those signals, right? Is it true or false? If I know h of e power j omega, if I know h of e power j omega for all omega, if I know this for all omega, then I can try to find the output of any given input signal, and that given input signal should be something like linear combination of complex exponentials. Then I can find the output just with the help of this one, right? It means for LTI systems, if I know h of n, then I can find the output. There is no doubt at all. We can calculate this output. And if I know h of e power j omega, which is nothing but dt ft, discrete time Fourier transform of h of n, if I know this one, then also I can find the output y of n from this. If I know this for all omega, then also I can find this, right? Any one is general. Impulse response are, this is known as frequency response of the system. Why this is frequency response of the system means, when the input is e power j omega, the output I am going to get is h of e power j omega into e power j omega, right? Is the output I am going to get. That's why this is known as frequency response of the system. Gain of the system at frequency omega is nothing but h of e power j omega. And one more thing about this one is, h of e power j omega is a, that can be a complex number, right? Let us have some notations about this. Real part of h of e power j omega plus j into imaginary part of h of e power j omega. These are the notation, imaginary part I, R means real part. This can be written like polar coordinate form also. Let us try to recap this. X plus jy is a rectangular form. This can be written like r e power j theta, where r equals to root x square plus y square, and theta equals to tan inverse y by x, right? Can someone tell me what is x here in terms of r theta? E power j theta means cos theta plus j sin theta, right? X equals to r cos theta and y equals to r sin theta. This can be written like this also. Magnitude of h of e power j omega into e power j into phase of that one, angle. This is a notation for angle, right? Phase of h of e power j omega. Yeah, can someone tell me what is mod h of e power j omega here? In terms of real part and imaginary part. Yeah, I can speak out. What is this?
Square root of?
Yes, square root of?
H over e power j omega whole square plus hi e to the power of j omega whole square.
Yes, that's fine. And similarly, angle h of e power j omega is nothing but tan inverse h of e power j omega divided by h of e power j omega. It's angle or phase. phase introduced by the system at frequency omega. This is the gain introduced by the system at frequency omega. Gain introduced by that LTI system at frequency omega. This is mod h of e power j omega. The phase provided by the system. Okay, that is fine. Let me go to this slide. Let us start some example. Frequency response of ideal delay system. Ideal delay system means y of n equals to x of n minus nd. Can someone tell me how to represent this in terms of LTI system? Yes, what is this impulse response h of n? Yeah, what is the impulse response for this?
N minus nd.
Yes, del of n minus nd, right? Where nd is some positive, some integer, nd is integer. Del of n minus nd. Because I'm replacing x with delta, then the output I am going to get is known as impulse response. This is nothing but x of n convolution with delta of n minus nd, which is equals to x of n minus nd, right? Okay, how to find impulse response for this system? This is given to you. Let me consider x of n equal to e power j omega n implies y of n equals to e power j omega n to n minus nd, right? I can write like this, e power j omega n into e power minus j omega n d. This is nothing but my input x of n. And this is my h of e power j omega, right? When the input is e power j omega n, the output of the LTI system I am going to get is e power j omega n into h of e power j omega, right? This is nothing but frequency response of this ideal delay system, e power minus j omega n d. H of e power j omega equal to e power minus j omega n d when that is an ideal delay system. This is the frequency response for ideal delay system. You can try to find this in another way also. Suppose I know h of n equals to delta of n minus nd, then how can I find frequency response? Minus infinity plus infinity h of k into e power minus j omega k, right? Now if I do this, minus infinity to plus infinity k minus nd e power minus j omega k, then what will be this one?
E to the power of minus j omega nd from impulse, yep, property.
Yeah, this is e power minus j omega nd. This is e power minus j omega nd. Because for k naught equals to nd, for k naught equals to nd, this is 0. 0 and something is 0. This term is non-zero only when k equal to nd. For k equal to nd, delta of 0 is 1. 1 into e power minus j omega nd, k equal to nd, right? It's nothing but e power minus j omega nd. If you want, you can find the impulse response. If you want, you can find the frequency response of the system with the help of h of n. Or you can do like this also. Anything is fine. You can take the input e power j omega n and try to find the output. And if you got the output like e power j omega n into something, that whatever something left over, that is known as frequency response of the system. Any procedure is okay. You can find in any way. No issues. Let's try to analyze this further. I want to find the real part of this and imaginary part of this one. The real part of e power minus j theta is cos theta, right? Imaginary part of e power minus j theta is minus sin theta, because e power minus j theta equals to cos theta minus j sin theta. Again, how in the same manner, cos omega and d is the real part, minus sin omega and d is the imaginary part. Magnitude of this one is 1, right? And phase of this is minus omega and d. See, if you are having h of e power j omega equal to r e power j theta, r e power j theta, where r is some positive constant, r e power j theta, then r is known as magnitude. In this case, r equal to 1, right? And phase of this one corresponds to theta, right? R e power j theta. Here theta is nothing but minus omega and d. It's a phase, it's a magnitude. This is a linear phase system. This is the phase is changing linearly with respect to omega, right? Because n d is some constant. For example, n d equal to 2, then this will become like minus 2 omega. Phase is changing linearly with respect to omega. This is linear phase system. This ideal relay system. Yeah, this is, as I said, if I am able to represent the given signal x of n as a linear combination of eigenfunctions. See, all of these are eigenfunctions, right? E power j omega k n is an eigenfunction. If I am able to represent like a linear combination of eigenfunctions, then the benefit I am going to get is, this is the benefit I am going to get. The output can be expressed like sigma k alpha k into eigenvalue for this. Eigenvalue for this function is nothing but h of e power j omega k into e power j omega k. That's the benefit I am going to get. Frequency response of real h of n. The frequency response of the system. Let me go with the same notation, standard notation. See, not to worry about this whether k or n. In textbook, they are following n. No need to worry about this. You can go with n or k. Anything is fine. That is just name change, right? No need to worry about name changes. H of n e power minus j omega n is a DTFT, discrete time Fourier transform for H of n. Suppose H of n is real. Let H of n be real. Then what about complex conjugate for n, H star of n? What is the complex conjugate for 2 star? What is the complex conjugate for 2?
2.
2, right? What is the complex conjugate for 2 plus J3? 3. Yeah. What is the complex conjugate for R e power J theta? Let me consider 2 e power J theta.
2e to the power of minus j theta.
2e power minus j theta, right? Yeah, that's fine. What is the complex conjugate for j2?
Minus j2.
Yes, minus j2 is the complex conjugate for this. Complex conjugate for real thing is nothing but same as h of n. When h of n is real, it's a complex conjugate. Now I can do this. If I try to apply complex conjugate both sides, see, suppose A equal to B, then A star is nothing but B star. is valid. There is no issue with this one. I'm trying to apply complex conjugate both sides. This side also. Oh, can someone tell me what is complex conjugate of CD?
C conjugate into D conjugate.
Yes, C conjugate into D conjugate, right? If I do complex conjugate for this side, then I can split into parts. Conjugate of this and conjugate of this one. Like this I can do. And can I erase this part? I can remove this, right? Because H star is nothing but H. Because that is a real. I consider it as real. Then, what about complex conjugate for e power j theta? E power minus j theta.
E power j theta.
Yes, e power j theta, right? Then I can simply remove this. I can change the sign to plus. It's a complex conjugate for that one. Can I call this as h of e power minus j omega? I am claiming that this is nothing but h of e power minus j omega. Is it true or false?
Yes, sir.
Is it true, right? Because h of e power j omega equals to h of e power j omega equals to, yeah, let me rewrite this once again. This is my h of e power j omega. If I try to replace omega with minus omega, both sides, and replacing omega with minus omega, both sides. See, this can be written like j into minus omega, right? Minus j omega is nothing but j into minus omega. Replace omega with minus omega. Then minus minus gets cancelled out. I am going to get j omega. From this, I can claim that this is true. When h of n is real, complex conjugate of h of e power j omega is nothing but h of e power minus j omega. Complex conjugate for e power j omega implies what is the magnitude of h of e power minus j omega? X plus j y. Is it true or false? X minus j y.
Same magnitude for both.
Yeah, it means complex conjugate and the term itself both are having same magnitude, right? This can be written as h star of e power j omega. Apply magnitude both sides of this equation, and this is nothing but equal to mod h of e power j omega, right? Then what is the symmetry? H of e power minus j omega equals to mod h of e power j omega. What is the symmetry? This is equals to this one. Even symmetric or odd symmetric? Suppose if you got x of minus t equals to x of t, is it even symmetric or odd symmetric?
Even symmetric.
Even symmetric, right? Similarly, you can say that this is even symmetric. Mod h of e power minus j omega equals to mod h of e power j omega. It means magnitude spectrum is even symmetric. symmetric for real H often, right? Magnus pattern is even symmetric. Even symmetric means we got like h of e power minus j omega equals to mod h of e power j omega. The negative side frequency magnitude and positive side frequency magnitude both are symmetric, right? They are equal, like that you can feel. Then what about phase spectrum? What about phase? If you satisfy this condition, our actual thing is h of e power minus j omega equals to h star of e power j omega. This can be written as, see, h of e power j omega can be written like mod h of e power j omega into e power j angle of h of e power j omega, right? Now if you apply complex conjugate both sides, then I am going to get mod h star is nothing but mod h, because this is real. Mod h means I am going to get mod h of e power j omega into e power j theta whole star equals to e power minus j theta angle h of e power j omega. Implies what is phase? See, this is nothing but mod h of e power minus j omega, but this is even symmetric. I'm writing like h of e power j omega only into e power j into angle of h of e power minus j omega. This is actually minus mod h of e power minus j omega into e power j into angle of h of e power minus j omega. But I know that this is same as this one. Minus is same as plus for magnitude, even symmetric. Now we can try to compare these two, this and this. H of e power minus j omega equals to minus angle h of e power j omega.
Phase spectrum is odd symmetric.
Yes, phase spectrum is odd symmetric. Minus angle h of e power j omega. Odd symmetric. Magnetic spectrum is even symmetric and phase spectrum is odd symmetric. When h of n is real. Let's try to consider sinusoidal response of LTE system. The input is some sinusoidal signal. For example, x of n equals to a cos omega naught n plus t pi. This can be written as follows. Is it okay or any issue with this? See, cos theta equals to e power j theta plus e power minus j theta divided by 2, right? A theta is nothing but omega naught n plus pi. And I am splitting that into two parts. E power j into omega naught n plus pi equals to e power j omega naught n into e power j pi. That's what I had in here. Okay, after doing this one, now what is the response for this?
Frequency shifting we'll get.
Okay, let me see this. This is my input e power j pi. This is some constant. And this is some constant. When this is my input, the output I am going to get is, output will be multiplied with gains, right? See, we have already seen this, right? Suppose my input is c1 e power j omega 1 n, c2 e power j omega 2 n, and the response I am going to get is, what is the response? When the real LTI system, j omega 1 into e power j omega 1 n plus c2 into h of e power j omega 2 into e power j omega 2 n, when that is LTI system. The same thing we can apply here also. Then the output we are going to get is into h of e power j omega naught, this one into h of e power minus j omega naught. If h of n is real, we are going to get one extra benefit, right? Yeah, what is that benefit? If h of n is real, this is equal to let me write this once again. E power j omega naught equals to mod h of e power j omega naught into e power j angle of h of e power j omega naught, and h of e power minus j omega naught equals to, when h of n is real, the magnitude spectrum is even symmetric, e power j omega naught, no need to write minus, into phase spectrum is odd symmetric, minus j angle h of e power j omega naught. Like this I can write. And if I try to substitute this into this expression, let's see what's going to happen. That's what I got. And if I try to apply that property, then x of h of n is real. And if you try to simplify that one, we are going to end up with this, right? We are going to end up with this expression. Just do this simple calculation after this. Replace this one with this term and replace first one with this term. Then we are going to end up with this one. It means when I input is this one, the output we are going to get is multiplied with gain at omega naught, mod h of e power j omega naught, you can see this, into mod h of e power j omega naught, and phase gets added. This is the phase we are going to add, right? Angle h of e power j omega naught. When the input is a cos omega naught n plus pi, then the output we are going to get is magnitude will be multiplied with, the amplitude will be multiplied with gain at omega naught. Is the gain at omega naught, and phase will be added, that phase corresponds to at frequency omega naught, right? Angle h of e power j omega naught. That's what we are going to get finally. For example, ideal delay system, h of n equals to delta of n minus nd, is the ideal delay system. In that case, we already saw this, right? H of e power j omega equals to e power minus j omega nd. The DTFT for this one is e power minus j omega nd. Implies magnitude of that one is 1 and phase is minus omega nd. Now, when this is the input, I am going to multiply this with this gain, right? This gain. Gain equal to 1. A into 1 is A. After that, I'll try to add a phase. I'll try to add this phase, right? Phase at omega naught. Here, phase at omega. This is omega, right? Phase at omega equals to minus omega nd. Minus omega nd is the phase. I'll try to add this phase. This is my signal. I'll try to add a phase of minus omega naught nd. After adding, this is output. If you want, you can cross check. This is ideal delay system with a delay of nd samples, right? Nd samples. If you want, you can take omega naught common. If you try to take omega naught common here, then this will become like omega naught into n minus nd after taking that common, which is nothing but x of n minus nd, right? This is x of n, this is x of n minus nd, replacing n with n minus nd. This is an ideal linear system. Let us consider h of n to be real and x of n like this. Yeah, can someone answer what will be the output y of n? We can explain the similar lines. Similar lines means we should tell in this format. When the input is a cos omega naught n plus pi, is the output we are going to get. Like this, you can answer. If this is omega 1, this will be omega 1, this will be omega 1, this will be omega 1. If this is omega 2, this will be omega 2, omega 2, and omega 2. And due to LTA system, linearity property, we can add the outputs, right? Like that we can do. If this is the input, we can try to find the output for individuals. Due to linearity property of LTA systems, we can club the outputs finally. The output of this one corresponds to this one multiplied with gain at omega 1. Mod h of e power j omega 1. And phase will be added to this. Phase at omega 1, right? Plus angle h of e power j omega 1. Plus, similarly, for this also you can try to find the output separately. Into gain at omega 2 and phase at omega 2 gets added. Gain at omega 2 and phase at omega 2 gets added. Similarly for this one, gain at omega 3 and phase at omega 3. That gets added. In that way, we can try to find the output. If h of n is real, this is a benefit we are going to get. Okay, is it periodic or aperiodic? See, my question is this. This is DTFT of HRN, or frequency response of the system. HRN e power minus j omega n. Is it periodic? This can be any sequence. This can be periodic or this can be aperiodic. No need to worry about that. Is it periodic? See, my claim is this is periodic with a period of 2 pi. Omega plus 2 pi. Try to replace omega with omega plus 2 pi, this side. H of n e power minus j into omega plus 2 pi into n. Yeah, what about this? Can I say this like this? Is it true or false? This is equal to this. Okay, can someone answer what is e power minus j 2 pi n? Yeah, can you speak out once?
1.
This is 1, right? This is 1 for all n belongs to j. For any integer n, this always equals to 1. Cos 2 pi n minus j sin 2 pi n. This always equals to 1. The second term is equal to 1, right? I can split into 2 parts. E power minus j omega n into e power minus j 2 pi n. This part is 1. It means that is nothing but h of e power j omega. It means h of e power j omega is periodic with a period of 2 pi. But what about analog case? This is for DTFT, right? DTFT is periodic with a period of 2 pi. Then what about continuous time Fourier transform? Is it periodic? X of f equals to integral x of t e power minus j omega t dt. Okay, is it periodic? Is it periodic or not?
No, sir.
Is it not periodic? Because if I try to apply plus 2 pi here, for example, this is not periodic. And then I am going to get like, see, this one is nothing but 2 pi f, right? 2 pi f t. Replace f with f plus 2 pi or something, whatever you want. Because t can be any real number, right? T can be any real number. See, e power j into something into n. Forget about this. Let me have this. E power j 2 pi into n equals to 1 for all n belongs to j. Suppose base of n, I have t. T belongs to r, right? For other than integer values of this n, this will fail, right? This won't be equal to 1. Here t can be any real number. That's why this will fail. CTFT is not periodic, but DTFT is periodic with a period of 2 pi. And even you might heard about this, right? Yeah, what you heard about this signal? Omega is same as and what are the
sir, you are not audible.
We have seen frequency of oscillations will increase.
Shall we wait or leave? Sai Vanilla?